have this SSC board, ICSE, CBSE, and what I know, you can correct me, I feel that those boards can start, schools, you know, start using the syllabus from 8th, 9th and 10th. Before that, I think everyone can follow any syllabus. I don't know, how does it work?
Noreena, I'd like to differ on that point a bit. So the SSC, like we very commonly call it, is actually the secondary school certificate, and that is a certificate that is issued by the state government. So that is a state board, okay? Then you have the ICSE, okay? That is the Indian Certificate of Secondary Education, which is an examination conducted by the Council for Indian School Certificate Examination. And this is a private board, unlike the SSC, which is actually a public board because it is a state board.
Oh, okay. Okay.
So that is the difference between the two boards. You asked me about the CBSE. So that again is the Central Board of Secondary Education. This is a board which is a national level board.
Oh.
So there are three different boards.
So one is a state level, ICSE is a
private board.
Private board, and this is a national board.
Yes.
Okay.
And this basically the CBSE has the public schools as well as the private schools. So you can actually both be governed by the CBSE.
So when we have these different boards, a child can shift from one board to another, and that's okay, right? From an SSC to ICSE or from an ICSE to SSC, that can be done?
Yes, of course you can do that.
It can be done.
Yeah.
And if a parent has a concern with regards to any of the boards, then what do they do?
So there is, every board has a redressal mechanism. For example, the ICSE has a council, okay? So if at all there is certain, if you're facing a certain issue, then you can actually, first of all, speak to the principal of the school and try to address it there. You have PTAs, like the parent teachers associations. So various associations that the school actually, you know, has, where you could actually go there and say that, you know, you're having a problem or you want to redress a certain issue or raise a certain complaint. Now, in the event that there is no redressal or, you know, there is absolute neglect or your complaint or your query is actually ignored, then you could write to the council. And the council will then investigate as to what exactly is the issue. They could also call for an inspection and find out, you know, basically send their inspectors to school and really to identify whether there is really a genuine issue or it's something which is.
So this is only for ICSE?
No. So again, you have the secondary board as well, like I said, the state board. You have inspectors out there also. Arina, I don't remember if, you know, any inspector visited your school, but I study in the state board and I did have these surprise checks wherein one fine day, you know, the teacher would say, okay, now, so you need to all tidy up. And we've got this inspectress who's coming to school.
Yeah, so we used to have that.
Yes. Yeah. So they also have some sort of this kind of an inspector and, you know, who comes and does just checks as to everything is in order or not. And if, I mean, at times they do speak to children and, you know, just do a one-on-one with them to identify if there are any issues, you know, that these innocent kids are facing.
Okay.
So there's definitely...
So there's SSC, ICSE and even CBSE has it?
Yes. So the CBSE would come directly under the aegis of the Ministry of Human Resource, and that's the HRD Ministry. There again, you have a board and you can take up your grievance with them.
Speaking to Germaine Pereira, who's a legal expert at Solomon & Company, which is one of the most leading and one of the oldest law firms, to learn more about law and the rights of kids and adults with disabilities, stay tuned on my channel and keep watching. Thank you.